Hey there, it's Julian with another Legacy League video with Elves. Today we are using my list from MKM Frankfurt that I used to top 8 the Legacy main event as well as win the super finals, which I'm still super amazed about, because last year I only got second place. Like, I lost in the finals in the 3 games to Lance back then, and I felt kind of like really sad. Maybe not sad about it, but I felt like, oh my god, I could have won the super finals and didn't. But yeah, this year I won them, and yeah, this list has been like super amazing for me thus far. Just before, I 5-0 the league with this, which means that we will probably go 0-3 drop now, now that I'm gonna show you this. But anyway, yeah, this is as straightforward as it gets with Elves, and I have my microphone turned on, perfect. It's basically, the idea is that we have no idea. Like, we don't really know. Oh, thanks for whoever followed, actually, while I'm recording this. I think it was Toby. Anyway, the idea is that we have no idea. We don't know what the meta is gonna be like. We have some vague ideas and some general, like, directions the format is heading, but we don't really know what's going on, so basically we wanna be the danger. I wrote about that in an article before, and like, when you're playing Elves, you should never forget that you are like probably the most scary thing your opponent has faced thus far, except for maybe some all-in reanimator decks, because they don't really know what's going on. Sorry. And yeah, I wanna capitalize on that. I wanna be the most dangerous, threatening Elves deck that you can have around. And once the meta changes, and we might need to make some changes to adapt to that, we will do that. But for now, I'm running with 4 Heritage Druids and basically 4 of everything. Also the 4th Natural Order, because Progenitus has been really, really good for me thus far. And technically you could have it in the sideboard, but then you lose a sideboard slot, and we want to be prepared for like all the craziness that might be going on. Also 4 Abrupt Decays, because even though I only submitted 3 for the Legacy Premier League... Oh, wow! even though I only submitted 3 for the Legacy Premier League, what I learned at MKM Frankfurt is that this is just probably one of the best sideboard cards you can have in Elves, and it helps you out so much against Delver, which is the main reason I wanted. So yeah, for now I really want to roll with 4 and also 3 Surgical Extractions, because like, we're not technically weak to graveyard-based strategies. Like, for example, Mana Stretch is probably one of the best matchups, maybe even better than Death and Taxes, in before I lose my next week's Super Premier League match against McDoyle on Manolith Stretch. I don't know. And also, like, when you play 6 discard spells, Surgical gets better, and when you play more Surgicals, discard gets better, so it's like, the idea is to maximize on that, because you could also play Flusterstorm, because that's much better against the show-and-tell-based strategies, even though, like, you can't take Sneak Attack, which is probably the biggest problem you have in the matchup, since we also don't have needles. So I like this now. I like this. I really like this. And this is basically the last slot. Like, you could play this in the main deck and then add something in the sideboard. But for now, I'm, yeah, rolling with this. And we are up against Brian Cook for the first round. And probably, like, if you're new to Legacy, this guy, I probably can't say invented the Epic Storm, but he might even have, but yeah, he is the name that pops up for you whenever you try to find any information on the Epic Storm. He also has a website about it up, and yeah, so let's see. Ah, he's playing from class, okay. I would like to play first, yes. So the thing, okay, this hand is pretty good against the Epic Storm, I would say, because it can kill on the third turn. I will keep this. Unlike playing against Ad Nauseam Tendrils, Deathrite Shaman is much less important, because they usually don't even need Past in Flames. They are the best Ad Nauseam deck in the format, and I think I will just get a Dryad Arbor here, and depending on what he does, I might even try to kill him on the second turn, which is not super unlikely. Like, if you find Quirion Ranger, that's gonna be pretty good. But let's see. I usually say, when you play against a deck, especially if you're on the play, if they make 10 tokens in the first turn, that's not enough. But if they make 12 tokens in the first turn, it's probably enough. Oh, okay. And since I didn't play an elf, but went for Senate, it's slightly more likely that I have Glimpse of Nature in hand. He still goes for Natural Order, which I think he could have delayed by a turn, because Natural Order isn't really doing anything on the next turn. But maybe he just needs the mana that way. Okay, So I can play Glimpse and then Nettle Sentinel, and then I have 2 mana, so basically I need to draw a 1 mana elf of 2 draws, which is not super unlikely. Or I can go for it next turn, which is much more likely to win. But if he goes for goblins next turn and flashes back Cabra Therapy, I'm out of glimpse. And that's bad. So I should probably just try to go for it here. This card, well, actually doesn't help, does it? No, not really. Because I also have to bounce an elf, and unless I draw a Birchler Ranger, I guess in that case it helps. Okay. Well, it helps that he found another glimpse, because now he's less likely to Cabra Therapy glimpse, like in the blind. Okay, now he's just gonna drop one more card. And I'm bouncing this, though there's one less annoying trigger I have to worry about. Doesn't really make a difference. Okay, so killing him next turn is, I would say, we're more than 50% to kill him on the next turn, depending on what he does. And I also factor probably eventually drawing Natural Order into that estimate. And I'm bouncing this because I need that. Basically, when you have a decision like this, and it's pretty much in a vacuum because he can't attack, you want to bounce this, because this will eventually untap during your combo turn, and then you have, like, this, you can attack with that. Whereas if you bounce this, and then you have this in play, this won't untap all by itself, and then you might be short one attacker or something. And we could also just, like, okay, no Natural Order. That would have been too easy, I guess. Am I actually recording? Yeah. Huh. So I could get Visionary here, and I don't hate that. I could also get another Nettle Sentinel, or I could play this, but that's the worst. I could also bounce this and replay this to draw a card, and hopefully it's a 1 mana elf, then we can play this and continue without using the Cradle. But on the other hand, if I use the Cradle now, I can still play a Cradle later on once I draw one. I think I'm gonna go for the Visionary here. I'm not really concerned about mana. Oh yeah, that helps. Oh yeah, that helps even more. Oh man, I should have blown my nose before doing this. And I should have made for better lightning. Is this better? Yeah, probably. Yeah, I will yield, well, at least to the trigger. Another glimpse. Okay, now I think it's time for the glimpse music. Is this the glimpse music? No, that's not the glimpse music. Oh, damn. I got the hotkey wrong. This is the glimpse music. No! Now I feel confident in using the glimpse music. This is just showboarding, by the way. We're not playing around anything here. And also, I like the song. But it's not really a song, I guess. It's a piece of music. No! Oh, okay, we got it. Okay. He's seen enough. I like all of these. And I guess I should also like this, mostly because it's quite good against Empty the Warrens. Like, it blocks the token and it gains life of the creatures we sacrifice to the Empty. Taking out this, like, I sometimes I like keeping this against Storm because they proactively play out their LEDs against me. But this deck, like, the Epic Storm is much faster than Nauseam Storm. And, like, in Storm terms, in general Magic terms, they're both fast in a way, but yeah, Ad Nauseam is tendrils is more grindy. And yeah, so don't want this. I usually don't want my glimpses. Because they can get clunky and, like, I have less experience against the Epic Storm. Maybe I want glimpses against the Epic Storm, like, it's more of a goldfish race. But I don't know. So usually I take out, like, two of these. Oh, definitely not Deathlotrim. Deathlotrim is, like, a great creature in the matchup. Blocks tokens and, like, gives you some reach and stuff. Yeah. Should probably take out one of these. Actually two. Maybe I should take out another one of those, even though it's a 1-drop, and 1-drops are, like, good because they trade for tokens. Also, against Storm, when I take out, like, all my glimpses, usually take out, like, one or two of these, but, like, I'm really thinking about this in terms of golden tokens, and I want my two toughness creatures. And then I just want to win with this, or, like, cradle into this, or Haka's this. I guess Surgical on Burning, which is also quite good. Yeah, so, enough music. Oh, and why did I even build an overlay when I don't use it? So you can see much more now. Could you see the rest when I did this? Yeah, I guess you couldn't see the lens, but those won't change. I think I'm going with this. Like, I'm actually torn on this because I really don't know. I could be more of a goldfish race. In which case this wouldn't be as good anymore. Like, this isn't even, like, good. Like, it's much better against Storm or Ad Nauseam Tendrils, whereas the Epic Storm, it's like, yeah, it's still good, but not as good as it could be. Sometimes you send it for this and it's like, ugh. They are, like, at 7 life or something. They're like, ugh, now I can't go for the graveyard unless I have bounce, and yeah. And then they are, once you have this and they are on low life, the thing that you're most vulnerable to is the tutor chain. And the tutor chain is really something you can hardly interact with. Like, you can surgical. The problem about surgical is, like, the idea of a tutor chain is to get there without using the graveyard or your life total as a resource to generate enough storm. The problem is, once you use surgical, it's like 2 storm for the opponent. 1 storm for, like, playing the card and 1 storm for losing 2 life. So it's quite hard to interrupt the tutor chain with surgical. And yeah, but that's more like for a different matchup anyway. His hand, his 6 also has Rite of Flame, LED therapy into lands. Yeah, he can't send them back. Like, he has a lot of life top decks. I will keep this. It has interaction. It's weak to an early empty. Unless I draw a second cradle, I guess. Because if I draw a second cradle, I can go, like, turn 1 this, turn 2 this, this, and this, and then bam, bam, bam. That's how we roll in Elves, like, bam, bam, bam. That's the game plan. Cards I want to see with Thoughtseize that I can take. I don't know. You will see. Against Ad Nauseam Tendrils, there's even a chance I would play this or this in the first turn, but since this deck is that fast, I probably just have to lead on Thoughtseize. It's unfortunate that he knows that we don't have Surgical, so he can pretty safely, like, use Brainstorm to hide cards. Oh, he doesn't. Okay. Okay, so what am I got? Next turn he's got 2 mana, 3, 4, 5, 6. So he can make, like, 1, 2, 3. Well, this is mana neutral with Dark Ritual, so it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 goblin, 14 goblin tokens. And depending on what he draws, even more, which could be enough. So it's then it's like our turn, we do this, then it's his turn, he attacks, and then we get back. I guess we have to take the Dark Ritual here. Like, these are... Actually, he doesn't have red... Oh, he does have red mana. Yeah, these do pretty much the same. I guess this can't find Tendrils unless he brought it in. But I'm not scared about Tendrils. Like, this on the other hand can find... Well, it can find Ad Nauseam, but only if you get rid of the Burning Wish first. I guess you can imprint it into the box. So he's got, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. Which is exactly enough to go for Ad Nauseam, and that will probably kill us. Like, against Storm, Ad Nauseam Tendrils, they have much worse Ad Nauseams, and I've said that name so many times, it probably starts sounding weird. So yeah. Maybe even this. Because this can't find it, but what if I take Dark Ritual? It's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This, but then he's got so many top decks. It's blah. Whereas if I take Burning Wish, maybe sometimes they have Infernal Tutor on the sideboard, so they can go like Burning Wish, Infernal Tutor, Ad Nauseam. Nah. If I let him keep the Dark Ritual, Chemotherapy is an insane top deck. But say I take this, then he goes like 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, then he can't. Yeah, he can use this. Then he goes like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's the 14 goblins you talked about. Oh, actually, less because we take fewer. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then it's 10 goblins plus maybe more, depending on what he draws. If you take this, then it's Ad Nauseam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Well, and 7 if he imprints something. If he draws a land, that's bad for him. He doesn't know what's on top. Yeah. What if you take Chromox? Like, that's the most unintuitive thing to take, but I guess Chromox makes it so that he can't use this next turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You take Chromox, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then we still get Goblin Tokens into our face, 1, 2, 3, I don't hate it. Then we take like 1, 2, 3, 4, so it's 8 Goblin Tokens, that's probably not, he probably wouldn't go for that. Even if he draws something that's 10 Goblin Tokens, he might go for it. Since we're on 17 basically and we have no board presence, it's hard, but I think I'm gonna take a Dark Ritual. Then on his turn, he's probably just gonna cast Infernal Tutor to find another Dark Ritual and pass. I think that's fine. Also, this makes Surgical and... Well, Chemotherapy still is kind of okay as a top deck, but Surgical is like an even better top deck now. Maybe I should set a stop in this draw step to be like, ah, we drew Surgical, sure. Like, oh, damn, I didn't remove my draw step thing. And then he thinks like, oh no, he's next leveling me. He doesn't have Surgical, so he's even... more confident in this line, which might very well happen. Just gonna spam F2 to jump right through it. Fetching an upkeep because he doesn't want to draw this volcanic. Oh, Brainstorm? Ponder? Hardcast Probe? No. Yeah, Ponder, okay. Let's see. He didn't shuffle place under... Did he have Underground Sea? Yeah, he had Underground Sea. Is it the same edition? Yeah, it is. And another Ponder. Okay! So we still have Perfect Information, Dark Ritual, Mox, Wish, and Tutor, and then plus X, yeah. Now that we drew a second Elf, we are getting into a territory where we can even hardcast Crot of Behemoth two turns from like our next turn. So basically 3 turns from now. It could still be good enough, especially since he didn't find Caber Therapy yet. I guess they also sometimes side out some of the discard. That's something I've noticed about Storm against Elves quite a lot. Like they take out like half the discard a lot of times, which makes Mindbreak Trap a little bit better. Even though overall it's like okay. Like if you have permanent hate, Mindbreak Trap is much better. Because it buys you the time to get into your permanent hate. Okay. So do I like I could also just like play a lot of Dryad Arbors. But the line I'm scared of is Burning Vision to Pyroclasm. Say I get two I really should have blown my nose. I get 2 Dryad Arbors here, then next turn I've got then I tap this 3 lands to cast this, and then I tap this for 4, 3, 6, think I'm gonna go with this. This is kind of middle of the road, I guess. Yeah, but I still don't hate it. Because that way, if I draw a 1 mana elf next turn, I can cast this. And then the 1 mana elf. And then tap these to tap this, and then I get a much better, like, I get much better value of Cradle. Okay, let's see. Dark Ritual, Dark Ritual. Chromox probably imprinting one of the tutors. Or for nothing, but it's probably tutor imprint. Burning Wish imprint, okay. So it looks like he's going for Ad Nauseam. I guess technically he could also go for tokens, but it looks like going for Ad Nauseam seems much better. Oh, I clicked away one of the cards he had in hand, but I guess he didn't know about that. Okay, let's see. He still has a land drop. He's got technically one mana floating. I think if he finds an LED, we are toast. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good for him. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's already good enough to kill us with Tendrils, right? Yeah. Yeah, assuming he has a Tendrils in the sideboard, which he should have. Or even like in the main deck. Like, if there's a Tendrils in the 75, we are dead. Man, Sochiku would have been really sweet. And there it is. Tendrils into our face.
Combo whore.
Okay, you got that. Don't really want to make any changes. I think that's... I guess Glimpse would have been quite good in this game had we drawn. Actually, it wouldn't have been. We died after our second turn. Yeah, I think I'm still gonna go with this. I don't hate it. If that was a Cradle, I would like this hand much better. Like, I think if one of these was a Cradle, I would totally keep this hand, or if this was a Cradle. Because if there's a Cradle, we can kill with Natural Order on the third turn, and like he needs to make an insane amount of tokens to stop that. Just hate mulliganing. Like, this hand is a plan, but yeah. I guess we have to go with this then. He kept keep seven. That can't be good for us, and I have to use Cavern Therapy here, and I'm likely gonna name Lions or Diamond. Against Storm, you usually wanna name the 3 mana spells Cavern Ritual and Lions or Diamond, and since he doesn't play Cavern Ritual, because that's like the big difference between the Epic Storm and Ad Nauseam Tendrils, I have to go for Lions or Diamond. Whoops! Is it there? No. Naming a tutor isn't like really good because he's got 2 sets of tutors, Burning Wish and Infernal. Okay, so let's see. He has Duras up that takes a Natural Order, and then the turn afterwards, like he goes for Brainstorm, probably shuffles away the Tendrils, unfortunately. I guess? No, that doesn't really help. Did he side in Tendrils, or does he have, like, all the lists I saw of him, he had it in the sideboard. And he might have sided in, maybe he has 2 in the sideboard actually. Because otherwise, if you take out Burning with Surgical, it can get awkward. So if he goes for Duras here, so Brainstorm isn't up next turn, I'm... Depending on what I draw, I might actually flashback on... I can't really flashback on Tendrils, I have no way to remove it. And I don't even know if that's gonna be good. So you would probably flashback on either Duras or Burning Wish, but let's see. Probably gonna play Underground Sea because he needs to. Oh, okay. Oh, that's interesting. He's playing around the second. Oh, Surgical? Well, it doesn't. Oh, yeah, Surgical actually does help. That's cute. Haha! Well, it kinda helps, I guess. Okay, that's really cute. I probably should float mana first for no apparent reason. And now he goes for Brainstorm. And then I really don't know what to name. I could name Dark Ritual, I could name Burning Wish, I could name Tendrils. The thing is, afterwards I'm gonna shuffle, so I really wanna hit something. He must shuffle away. He's very likely putting Tendrils second from the top, because he really doesn't want it in his hand. So he's probably only hiding one of these. So how important is Natural Order to me here? It's actually more important than it seems. Like if I draw, say, a Quirion Ranger, I'm at 3 mana already. And then I can get like a 5/5 to start beating down, which is actually quite okay. But I really don't want to take yours. I would probably name Dark Ritual or Burning Wish. I think. Like, I could be super ballsy and just name Lion's a Diamond. But I think I'm gonna name Dark Ritual here. Yeah, hit. Double Duras, okay. And now we are reducing him to, well, only having like 3 discard spells and 3 lands. So he's like the worst Grixis deck ever. But we are also, like, we don't have anything, but he needs more critical mass than we do. Okay, Dark Ritual. And then I just have to do this right away. Because I don't want him to draw what he put on top. Which is probably Burning Wish and Tendrils. Actually, we know that it's Burning Wish and Tendrils. So, do I want to remove the rest? Okay, let's take a look at the deck. I think that's... I'm going to do it like this. So, 1 Tendrils for Rites, of course. 4 Tutors for Burning Wish. Discard-wise... Actually, he has a lot of discard against us. He's got 6 discard spells still. Which is probably what he plays. Like, that's... The last time I checked, they played 6 discard spells. Yeah, pretty straightforward. Actually, he didn't bring in anything against us, did he? I guess he doesn't have to. Yeah, so he's just drawing towards mana and some kind of tutor or nauseam. Also no past and flames in the main deck, like I was thinking that. Maybe one or none. I think his most recent list didn't even have past and flames. They don't even need it much. And then it's got like Duras, Cavatherapy, that's fine. He might take away both of these, and then we just hopefully draw, say, Deathrite Shaman and then something. Like, Deathrite Shaman plus Quirion Ranger has 5 damage a turn, which is like pretty good. Oh, yeah, I wanted to remove these. That was something. Sometimes you don't want to remove the cards from the side, from the deck. When your opponent, say, your opponent is like, he's drawing towards a very small amount of outs during a very small time frame. Then you usually want to, like, and if mana isn't the out, then you just want to leave in the mana, because that makes it less likely for him to draw whatever he's looking for. But this game is probably going to go longer, and in that case, I don't want him to have, like, an integral part of his deck. Deathrite? Or Quirion Ranger? Oh no, but now we don't have Natural Order anymore. But I guess we can always draw that. But first we need to draw a Visionary, yeah, something like that. But I sided out like 2 Visionaries or something. Oh, that helps. Yeah, that actually does help. Oh no, I keep forgetting that we don't have Natural Order. anyway. Say I get Dryad here and then I draw into Cradle and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. Say if we get Dryad here and draw Visionary into Cradle, it's like Visionary, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana. Yeah, that's probably a line. Visionary into Visionary, maybe? Okay, now it's getting super unlikely. Did he shuffle off the Ponder? Did not shuffle. Meh. So at this point, we're just gold fishing, unless we draw more Disruption. But what would we disrupt? His discard spells. If you get anywhere close to killing him with a Behemoth, he's probably just gonna fire off Cavatherapy on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So now if you draw Visionary into Cradle, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, yeah. Then we got 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 9, that's 14. Yeah, if we draw Visionary into Cradle now, oh please don't play a mana spell. Okay, Cavalry Therapy is fine. If we draw Natural Order here, we attack for 10. If you draw Visionary into Natural Order, we attack for... Oh, I should know that. 12 or something, I guess. 1, 2, 3. It's like... Actually, no, it's more. It's 16. I'm stupid. That's just your average three creatures attacking pile. I guess I'm not gonna play that one out and keep it in hand, but doesn't really make a difference since he can't go for the graveyard anyway. Unless he goes to pass in flames from the sideboard. And him having this makes it less likely for him to go. Oh, wow. If this brainstorm fizzles, well, I can't really say then we're in a good position, but then I feel a bit relieved, but he's playing 8 tutors. And even just making 8 goblins here would probably do it. Imprint Jewels, Lotus, where's my mouse cursor? Here. Oh, there's the Burning Wish. What's your Burning Wish? She wished for a weapon, but not for the skill to wield it. Also, since we saw four Infernal Tutors in the main deck, he doesn't have one on the sideboard, so this is probably... No, it's probably not going to be random tendrils. What's it going to be? Is it probably just goblins? Dark... Oh, he's got a Dark Petition sideboard. Okay, that makes sense. That's a problem. And he also hasn't made a land drop yet, and 14 is still quite comfortable for this deck, at least. So let's remove all of these. Or is he really just... Did he actually have empty in the main deck here? He didn't. Oh, wow. Oh, but he had tendrils in the main deck. Okay. So I was thinking like if he had somehow found a way to remove the Burning Wish, but yeah, he has tendrils in the main deck still. But this must be... Or maybe he's just... He could also make goblins. He could make like 14 goblins. But he's going for Ad Nauseam. Should be good enough to kill us here if he's got tendrils in the sideboard. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah. Guess this. But this way we're dead, dead. Not only dead, but dead, dead. I guess I can have six here. Oh, actually, should I?
Yeah.
I would have totally. Might backtrap that Ad Nauseam. Or would you say mind broken that Ad Nauseam? Okay, okay. Oh, it's his turn to showboat. Go ahead, try to kill me with Grape Shot. That would be sweet. But I think he doesn't have enough storm to go for that. Or maybe he can get to enough storm if he's got Dark Petition the sideboard. But it's probably harder without Dark Rituals.
Combo whore.
Anyway, guys, see you next round.